about you and your contribution, and it can be known for two. This is the title of my presentation, and it is way too long. Okay, so I'm so big now. So who am I? I am Tanisha Kalia, and I work at the Drupal Association as a full-time employee and in the marketing and outreach team. And this position has been sponsored and made possible by Srijan Technologies Private Limited. And thank you, Srijan, for doing it. So I am a content producer. That's my sister. I am a content producer. I basically turn web content and communication content into the design pieces, stage them, launch them on site, and monitor it so that it performs better, and generally make a lot what Drupal Association do look better and perform better. So that's my job. If I would like to frame it in one sentence, I make things look spiffy. You can Google about it. The word spiffy. Okay, so you can find me on drupal.org under the username Tanisha Kalia, and I don't have a very informative profile, so excuse me. You can also see me on Twitter at Tanisha Kalia with a capital T and K, although capitalization doesn't matter in Twitter, but to be accurate, that's how my profile looks. I live in Faridabad, and if you don't know about that place, it is basically the fourth most polluted cities in the world. So that's where I come from. So that was the blurb about me. So it's been more than a year since I have been, or maybe I have come across Drupal, and I have been hearing these two misconceptions. I am not writing code anymore, or maybe I don't want to write code to contribute, and I am not a developer. So these are the two misconceptions, not only in Drupal, but in the overall open source we hear about. And let's see what these has to say. It's really the Drupal community and not so much the software that makes the Drupal project what it is. So fostering the Drupal community is actually more important than managing the code base. So basically he is directing that the strength of Drupal is you. And then if you fall into the category, just a minute, it doesn't have battery, how do I charge? There's no point there.
So there is a JSON code in this. Yeah. Is it the charger, right?
Can you please pause that? One of those misconceptions that I mentioned previously. So then congratulations. There are so many other ways to contribute, not just the code base. So also the non-code is also important for the community. So, Catherine Waldrick, I am not sure if you guys know about her. She works at AAA, that is the American Automobile Association. And this is what she has to say. Not everybody needs to be a hardcore PHP developer or become a core contributor as a part of Drupal journey. Contribution is appreciated by all different roles in different aspects. So I took the screenshot from Drupal Minneapolis 2020 contribution events page, and I hope this make it more clear. And then we are always baffled with the question, why should we contribute? Everybody has a question. So what do you think? Why should we contribute? Anyone?
We have done. You should have written those.
That's okay.
But yeah, we
agree. Maybe we divorce. All for you. And how? Documentation. basically, if you like writing, editing stuff on Drupal or maybe anywhere, you can simply go in there and edit, re-edit, update any core module, anything you like. And it's basically for people who are who have interest in technical writing or maybe writing. They can pay forward by documentation. And Drupal Camp Delhi, that was my first Drupal Camp ever. We had documentation in our contribution. We did documentation as a contribution, and Kimmy Mahajan, she is from Sujan, she did her first documentation contribution in there, and all she said after getting out of the doors was, Tanisha, thank you for introducing me to such kind of documentation, such kind of contribution, and I really like doing this and I would pay it forward doing it. If you are very frequent with other languages, you can help in translate. There are so many core modules, there are so many things that needs your attention in translation, and in there you can know how to do that, how to really contribute, and it's relevant for anyone who can translate. Right now, Drupal Pitch Deck, it's an initiative from Promote Drupal. It's basically a crowdsourcing of all the case studies into a slide for the business purposes. And it is right now looking for translator, linguistic for the pitch deck, for the case studies in there. And if you have interest in doing this, it would be very great. Events happen. So many events are happening. Drupal camps all around the India. So contributing in events, there are Drupal cons. I know that could be a little intimidating for you guys, but Drupal camps are happening all over India. So you can go and be a part of it. Then you can find all the events in drupalcamp.com. That's a very pretty looking page where you can find all the events, all the meetup, everything, all the community related events in there. And then you have Drupal groups where you can find all the events regional wise. So it's, event is a really great place to contribute. And how could you do that? Organizing and volunteering is not an easy part, but doing that is a very important thing. These are the people who actually put in efforts to get us all under one roof, and we should really be thankful. So if you see these people around, they are the organizer of Drupal Camp Pune. So maybe thanks them, or maybe give them a little high five for all they are doing for the community. Dipin, Piyush, Saket, Shari, Deepak, Rahul, Yogesh, Ajit, Patrick, Vidit, Rujika, Archita, Amardeep, Sushil, any one of them. And the volunteer. Volunteering is also an important part of an event, and we often miss them, miss announcing them in an event. They are also a crucial part. So if you see them around, maybe you will see them around at the event. And then comes the photographer. So, photographs are the only tangible memories that you have about the camp. So, we should really thank them as well. Also, give them a little high five. Give them all the credits they deserve by mentioning them. Speakers like me, this is my first time and I know I can be not very good. But yeah, speaking at Drupal Camp would be a very intimidating job as well. And if you are looking for help to do, so we have a Drupal Diversity Speaker Workshop very soon for the first time speakers who would like to speak at Drupal events. So that will be happening on September 21st and 28th, and it's an online workshop. It would be basically dividing 5 people in a group and brainstorming them about how to contribute, how to speak, how to select the session, and everything around it. Attribution. People are doing contribution. How do we recognize them? That's how we do this. By getting them issue credits. Issue credits is basically a thing just like the photo credits you give to people. It's on D.O. And how do you do this? How it's been maintained and it's been added to your profile when you do something, when you speak, when you volunteer, when you organize, people give you credits around that, and it's been like you can see them on D.O. and when you see them, that's how your contribution are being measured. That's the way. That's how you can see how many contribution did I do. And again, by giving credits to people who give us all the tangible memories that we see in Drupal camps. And by sponsoring. Without sponsor, these Drupal camps would not be possible. So maybe if you see them outside, QAD 42, Gatsby, Valuebound, Accelerant, Spexby, and Strigen, just give them high five, because without them, we won't be able to come under this one roof for this event. And sponsoring is great.
Actually, the reverse is also correct. Even if you code, you can contribute in ways that don't involve code. So, which I realized this time, I'm a coder. I work on Drupal. But this time I contributed for GCP. I was not involved in issues. I helped with organization of this thing. And that in itself is a big contribution to the community. So,
yeah, it's like I just mentioned that. In the misconception slide, if you are a coder, it doesn't really matter, because you can also contribute under the non-code contribution, right? It's not a like tumhe karna hi karna hai. If you are a coder, you don't have to be just contributing in a code way or in a code base way. You can contribute in so many other type of contributions.
So in fact, there are a lot of things, not just code, yeah. Testing, reviewing, like at least triaging the issue queue. Mm-hmm. Like even in that section, there are
if you go under issue queue, you will get a lot of things to know.
Even like people like project managers and even they can pitch in and then they can do some management there and just triage the issue queue so that novice and an expert and then can take up. Then there are like hundreds of issues which are not clear who should take up or am I good fit to take that. With proper tag and proper triaging, it becomes very simple and it becomes clear which one should I pick and which one I can like forward it to someone who can do it. So even in that section there are multiple issues.
And yeah, you can go to the content issue queue.
Yeah.
You can find so many things that doesn't include code. Yeah, documentation. If you go on D.O, you will realize there are a lot of things that you need to explore other than coding.
In fact, being around the community is itself a problem.
Attending a Drupal camp because people are coming. People are listening, they are telling other people, their friends about it, that's how.
In this camp itself, I've seen like people, people like Rahul and they come with their wife.
Even Hussein comes with her, with his whole family.
Full family, get to know, future they know that they need to do.
Let's discuss this with everyone.